All right, we got time for some email questions that you sent in.
Okay, this first one comes from Andrea Pat, who says, can my child pray over his lunch at school? While covering for a fifth grade Bible class today, I found out the kids that were, quote, caught praying over their lunch at school were sent to the back table. Of course, my initial thought was, they can't do that. Is it legal to tell children that they can't pray over their lunch food, and if they do, they will be punished by having to sit at the back table?
This is one of the most outrageous things. Let me tell you something. We have rights if we're willing to fight for them. And if we're not, those who hate us will take away our rights. The idea that a child would in any way be punished because he or she prayed as he or she does at home over their lunch is an outrage. It is a violation of religious freedom. It is a violation of the First Amendment. And I can go down the list. Now, listen. Call the American Center for Law and Justice. Get one of the lawyers to write a demand letter to that school. If they will not comply immediately, bring an action for damages. I think it's time we start putting a hurting on some of those left-wing teachers who are denying children their rights. That enrages me. It should enrage you. And I know we're not supposed to go away angry and fire coming out of our nostrils and everything, but we've got to stand up. In a case like this, please call the American Center for Law and Justice, ask for a lawyer, and then go after that school system and let them. I mean, I think it's time we start asking for damages. We start making those school systems know if they take away the rights of these precious little children, they're going to have to pay for it. Once that happens, they'll begin to back off and say, oh, we can't do that. Okay.
You know, the interesting thing about this is she was covering for a fifth grade Bible class. I mean, how did those two things exist in one school?
I don't know what they're talking about.
Strange.
But anyhow,
go ahead. This is Elizabeth, who says, I'm a college student, completely lost, and I graduate in such a short time. My boyfriend and I just broke up, and life feels like a complete mess. I'm pursuing Christ daily, but depression and anxiety have completely taken over my life. How do I stay patient in the midst of God's work?
The Apostle Paul said of a truth, in Christ I lie not, I die daily. I think it's time that what you do is die to self, spiritually. I'm not talking about physically. It's time that you die to all the stuff that's going on in your life and say, look, I'm crucified with Christ, nevertheless I live. You've got so many things going on. You've got a love for your boyfriend who just walked away from you. You've got ambition, but you don't know what it is. You're completely unfocused. So you need to focus on the Lord and to say, Lord, I am yours. Take me and then lead me in the course that you have for me. And then surrender. Let go. And you haven't done it. You're holding on. Let go. All right?
This is an interesting question. This is from Michael, who says, in 1 Chronicles 21, it says that Satan incited King David to take a census of the fighting men, and this angered God, so he struck them with a plague. Now, my question is this. What was so wrong about taking a census of the fighting men?
You know, welcome to the club. I've struggled with that one for a long time. I really have. And I just said, God, what is the deal? Because if you go into the Old Testament in Numbers, they numbered the people, and God said, go out and number and count the numbers of fighting men, count the numbers of Levites, count how many children the Levites, I mean, it was, count how many firstborn animals. I mean, it was a counting, a census. So for some reason, what the only thing I can think of it is that instead of being God's army, it became David's army. And it was a thing of saying, I'm a big king in the middle of the Middle East, and I want to show off my power, and here's how I do it, by counting the troops. And this is the army I'm going to use to advance my career. That's the only thing I can figure. That was wrong. The other isn't. Okay.
Okay, this is Pete, who says, God promised me that I would be together with someone if I pursued her. That person has returned to her own country and is in a serious relationship with another person. Did God lie or willfully mislead me? I may have not heard God correctly, but I have been a Christian for a long time, and I believe I did. I'm confused.
I tell you, old buddy, God don't lie.
Yeah.
The Bible says God is not a man that he should repent. God is not a liar. God never lies. He is truth. He is yea and amen. You heard wrong. You imposed your will and made it the voice of God. You're praying and your will said, that beautiful girl's going to be my wife. And that's it. And yes, I heard God. You didn't hear any such thing. Get over it. She's gone on. She's getting married. Find yourself somebody else. And don't blame God for the fact that you weren't mature enough to hear him. Surrender to him. What's next?
This is Sonia who says, can I sow my tithe into a ministry online or on television and receive the same blessing? I'm not currently under a ministry, although I want to join somewhere. Also, the Lord has called me into ministry, but I want to make the right decision and work with the right people. How do I find the right relationships in ministry? I've been ordained, so I know it's all right to get started.
You hear those words, I'm going to sow into this ministry, and I've got to be under certain authority. Mm-hmm. You've got a concept of the body of Christ that's a little bit in error. The body of Christ includes everybody who loves Jesus, who's committed to Jesus, and all the ministries they're doing, their schools and their missionary organizations and their humanitarian organizations and their churches. And they're all part of the body. And so, rejoice in that part of the body and don't be saying, well, I've got to find exactly the relationship. The relationship is with Jesus, not with a piece of his body, and there are plenty of it out there.